everything changes.
Hello everybody out there on YouTube, this is your man Shattuck Stick. Hold up. Let me turn this down. You're seeing the gameplay. This game is Black Rock Shooter for the Sony PlayStation Portable. I cannot put any download links in the description for ISOs. The video may get taken down on my channel, may get taken down. But anyways, let me open up my phone and get to the story here that we're covering today. Let's see, bookmarks and... Alright, here we go. Now we're going to be talking about the game, the highly critically acclaimed game series, F-Zero. Now F-Zero is one of my favorite childhood games. I played F-Zero GX a lot, actually got really good at it. The game was freaking hard. Me and my cousins did nothing but play that game 24-7 until we got good at it. But anyways, Nintendo basically said they're not making another one for the time being, because Miyamoto says basically the entire controller interface will require a redesign and they just don't want to do it. And seeing as they already have Miyamoto working on Star Fox, I would guess if they did a next project, it would require Miyamoto, and I would hope that they would get Sega again on the project, because GX was done by the hands of Sega at it too. This is what he basically said in December. He said Nintendo as a whole is a Miyamoto said this: if we create a new type of controller interface and we find a controller interface that's particularly suited for F-Zero, then maybe we'll do something with it in the future. So basically he's saying, oh, when we find the control scheme for F-Zero, it'll work. Because you gotta remember, Nintendo games, they have to have the perfect control scheme. If you screw one thing up, it's over. Like, that's like the only series that can really like be allowed to mess up controls, because a lot of people change like the controls and stuff throughout it, is Smash Brothers. And that's because Smash Brothers is a fighting game. People change the controls regardless in their fighting games. Anyways, in December he said Nintendo as a whole has groups working on ideas for new hardware systems while we're busy working on software for the Wii U. We have production lines that are working on ideas for what the next system might be. So basically, if you didn't know, AMD basically released a statement, and Miyamoto released a statement earlier last month, that Nintendo was basically working on the next console. AMD really didn't release it, but they said they were making another chipset specifically for a company for something that would soon be in people's homes in the next few years. So that has to be basically the successor to the Wii U. And I don't want to go too off topic, but if we talk about that, I think the next F-Zero game might be on that system if they decide to do it, because what I think they're going to do is cut the cut the Wii U's lifespan shorter than what they originally intended it to be, because the hardware isn't powerful enough. I mean, you're using 3-year-old hardware, and even though it's stronger than the PS3 and 360, it's still not as strong as like the Xbox One and PS4. Xbox One and PS4 can hold up for a while, because what I feel is about to happen is PC hardware is about to hit that plateau where like the upgrades aren't gonna be as much as like, say for instance, you get a 600 Ti to a 700 Ti, 720 Ti to a 620 Ti. You're not gonna get that difference like you did now. Sorry, my phone's going off, but I was texting and stuff before this. I just wanted to get this out of the way before the night's, and then I have to go do my homework. But anyways, what's your opinion on a new F-Zero game, guys? I mean, I would rather be on the successor to the Wii U, because in all honesty, they could make a better game on more powerful hardware. So that's how I'm looking at it. And since the Wii U's lifespan, I don't think will last until the latest they'll cut it off is 2017. That's the latest they'll cut it off. I mean, it would have had a good 4-year lifespan, and that's all it needs. But I hope it sells over 200 million, because if it doesn't sell over 200 million, then it's basically a failure. The GameCube and Nintendo 64, people will argue, were failures, but they were successes. They were just failures to the previous works. Like the Wii was a major success as far as sales go. I mean, you can argue that it wasn't because people would just leave it to dust, but I mean, still, people use their Wii today. I know people who don't game and they still use their Wii. I know people who game and they still use their Wii. A lot of people who game, they'll have upgraded to the Wii when they play their Wii games on that. So everybody out there on YouTube, don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe. Share this video with your friends. Please tell me your opinions on the new F-Zero game. I mean, not new F-Zero game, but what you think about a new F-Zero game. And this is your man Shattuck sticking. I'm out. Peace.